You're right. The roster looks like Swiss cheese because of the injury issues. But there he is. He gets the empty netter versus Colorado. He scored an overtime winner against the Dallas Stars, the shootout winner against the Anaheim Ducks. I would call him an unlikely hero when the lineup is healthy, but he's taking advantage of his opportunity.
You know, and this is where you get an early lesson learned. This is Pittsburgh. This is a team without a half a dozen of their regular guys. So you've learned it this year. This isn't like, I'm not talking about this. You know what you're dealing with in Vegas.
Right. The offense has shown signs of life. They've scored a goal. Toronto has now in five consecutive periods. Andre Cash and company will try to keep that going tonight. Again, Toronto's 4-4-1. Vegas is 4-4. Vegas winning three in a row. Toronto two in a row. So pretty equal starts for these two teams who have big aspirations this year. We'll see who comes out on top next.
James, good evening and welcome to Toronto in this Tuesday night matchup between the Vegas Golden Knights and the Maple Leafs. Their first meeting since November of 2019. Vegas won that game. It was Toronto's fifth straight loss. That was Mike Babcock's last game as the head coach in Toronto. There is Austin Matthews. Five goals in five career games against the Vegas Golden Knights.
Well, Mitch Marner got on the board in the last game against Detroit. Now Matthews would like to uncrack the vault here a little bit against the Vegas Golden Knights. 25 shots, as you've seen in his start. Said his timing's a little off, conditioning's good. You got a banged up Vegas team, maybe the Knights tonight.
Vegas will have four of its top five goal scorers from a year ago. They're an injury away from having open tryouts as Matthews feeds out away to Nylander. Nylander in, Leonard with a stop, rebound, loose in front. Another chance that put high by Bunting. What a chance for Nylander and Matthews and Bunting.
Sheldon Keefe was telling us this morning how much this line loves to score. A breakdown in the middle of the ice catches Nick Hague stuck in the middle. And Nylander's in cold. Nylander, who's got just one goal at even strength here, tries to go up over the glove. Robin Leonard, a terrific stop. And as the rebound pops out, Michael Bunting's shot is deflected up over the net into the netting.
Face off in the Vegas zone. Toronto number one in the league on draws, and Matthews wins that one. TJ Brody is shot that was blocked by Evgeny Dadonov, who's asked that his name be pronounced the more traditional Russian way rather than Dadonov, which is what he had to say when he was in Florida and Ottawa. And so here's Dadonov with it. Olympic gear, that must be it.
Indeed.
Officials from Hockey Canada are here tonight. Watching players as they'll have their first set of meetings in a couple of weeks to start kneeling down an Olympic roster. There's lots of candidates on both sides. As Leonard's up to play it. Drops that back to Brayden McNabb. Tipped up by Jonathan Marchessault. And here's Nick Waugh with it. Moves that by Morgan Riley. And John Tavares bumping there with Riley Smith. He banks that off the skate of Marchessault, and Campbell had to be quick with that. Riley cross ice pass to Tavares. That's picked off. Moves back in by Keegan Kolesar. Travis Dermott spins back. That's spun around by Marchessault. Marchessault is three games behind William Karlsson for the most games played in Vegas franchise history. Karlsson's out. So Marchessault, assume he doesn't fall off a curb and break his leg.
I would say, don't even say it. Every time Vegas turns around, somebody falls down the steps and they lose somebody else for 6 weeks.
There's Leonard, leaving it there for Nick Hague. Long lead pass that bounced away from Matthias Janmark. Moved around by Jake Lecision, whose dad Curtis played over 1,000 games and won the Stanley Cup for the Colorado Avalanche. Alex Petrangelo, whose name is in ink on that Olympic roster. Back for Lecision. Banks it back around for Krebs. Now Hague trying to move it ahead, bouncing puck in behind the goal, Nick Hague.
Look at the activation of Hague way down in the offensive zone. Something for the Leafs to talk when they're on the ice to make sure they know where the defensemen are. They're not just standing at the point.
David Camp trying to clear that out. He got tied up there by Lecision. Now Rasmus Sandin back with his partner Timothy Liljegren. Familiarity from the Toronto Marlies. Played a lot of games together there and now paired at the NHL level. Liljegren moves that down to the Vegas zone. Stripped up there by Shea Theodore, another player who is a very strong candidate to be on the Canadian Olympic team. as TJ Brody has it back. Jason Spezza, rink wide for Jake Muzzin, who fires that down to the Vegas end. Madonna, tied up there by Ritchie. Now stolen by Spezza, the centering pass broken up. Able to clear it was Alec Martinez. Now gloved down and center ice by Brody. Vegas last here, November 7th, 2019. This is Sheldon Keefe's first time coaching against Vegas. And on Saturday, he'll coach against Boston for the first time.
And that seems just unbelievable that he hasn't coached against the Bruins yet.
Now picked up by Matthews. Shovels it back for Riley. Riley swings it back across. Dermott drops it down to Nylander. Thought Matthews was looking at the lacrosse move there for a minute behind the net. Now Haig on it, being shadowed there by Riley, who's jumped up. And Kolasar to the line, but not out. Bounces down to Haig. That pass picked off by Bunting. Centers it. Matthews, a shot. He ripped it wide. Bouncing puck right in front. The Donovs got it. Up for Kolasar. This time he does poke it out.
I think what Sheldon Keefe's going to like about that shift is when Riley went deep behind the net, Bunting was up over top, supported the puck. The play stays in the zone, and they end up with a pretty good scoring chance about it. He talked about they have to play away from the puck well enough to not waste the shift skating around in their zone. They did it perfectly there.
Back for it, one of four Vegas players who's left over from the expansion draft back in 2017. That Vegas team went to the Stanley Cup final in its first year. Vegas won 8 of its first 9 games in the regular season that first year. Picked up by Marner's got to wait for Tavares, who was dragged offside. Vegas has made the playoffs all 4 years. It's been in the league 3 times to at least the conference final, including the last 2 years.
Right now, with these injuries, Gord, I think their goal's got to be to stay stuck to the middle of the pack. Try and stay in it until they can get some players back.
Muzzin centers it. Matthews couldn't quite reach that. Leonard blocks the centering pass. Bounces back to Muzzin. This line is buzzing for Toronto. Here's Bunting with it. Down to Muzzin. He centers it. Knocked away by Theodore. This puck picked up by Peyton Krebs. First round pick of Vegas. 2019 draft, and now Brody back for it. Brody moves it ahead to Kasha. Kasha dribbles that down, and Leonard hangs on to that. Tonight's key parts of the game are brought to you by Napa Auto Parts.
Vegas is going to want to play tight. They can't play 5-4 games. Not with this lineup. They have to play tight, shorten the game down. And for the Leafs, Sheldon Keefe's talked about connecting the defense and the offense. Connect the forwards and the defensemen closer together so you play quicker, you keep the pace high, and the other team has a tough time staying up with you. The Leafs can do that. That's going to be a tough ask for Vegas in their current state.
Game 2 of a 5-game homestand for Toronto. Leafs played 9 of their first 13 games at home this year. Like a lot of Canadian teams, a home-heavy schedule early on. A lot of U.S.-based teams don't like playing games in October or even November. Simmons back with it. Got bumped there by Carrier. William Carrier drops that down to Chandler Stephenson. Stephenson swings it back to Petrangelo. And Petrangelo winds away from Simmons. Drops that back. And that shot was blocked. As Mike Amadio picked up on waivers from Toronto, had a block. Spezza centers a great chance for Ritchie, turned away by Leonard. And now Carey drops it back to Stephenson. Chandler Stephenson feeds that back down to the Toronto zone. Stephenson minus his wingers, Mark Stone and Max Pacioretty. In comes Lilligren. There's the move there around Martinez. Swings that back to Sandin. Across he goes. Kerfoot a shot that deflected wide. Marner back with it. Marner centers it. Tavares a shot. That bounced high. And Leonard swatted that away. Martinez. He's had along the boards. And Waugh couldn't clear it out. Now takes the return pass from Martinez. Goes rink wide. And Dodonov with it. Dodonov got squeezed off the puck by Lilliard. Now Sandin back with it. Chris crosses with Lilligren and then feeds it back to him. 7 gone here in the opening period. 4-0. The shots on goal in favor of Toronto. Kerfoot. Game center ice and taps that as McNabb goes back for it. on the board. That was Coughlin, Dylan Coughlin. Another player getting a look from Vegas. Zach Whitecloud also injured on the defense. Knocked down and moved up by Riley Smith, the Toronto native. Brings it across the Marshes, though. The return pass is blocked by Brody. In the corner is Matthews. Looks at for Nylander. That passing lane was blocked by Marshes, though. Pass it across. And it's swung around by Brett Howden. Back at the point. Petrangelo, a shot goes off Brody's stick. Now back at the point is Petrangelo again. Shoots. It's off the leg of Matthews. Matthews lifts that high in the air and skips it back down to the Vegas zone. Petrangelo to Janmark. And Matthews took that away. Playing straight time here in the first period. In comes Morgan Riley with it. Riley in, shoots, Leonard got a glove on that. The rebound cleared away by Martinez. Riley tried to gather up a loose puck. He spun and fell. Now Engvall's got it. Pierre Engvall, long reach, hooks that back to Dermott. Across he goes to Riley with a shot off the foot of Martinez. Kasha tied up along the boards, now scooped up by Engvall. Engvall spins and shoots, and Leonard knocks that away. Kasha swings it around to Engvall. Long time in the offensive zone here. And Kemp couldn't catch on that. Martinez gets tangled up there with the official and Kasha. Theodore lifts it high in the air and Vegas starts to change. Toronto, the first six shots this opening period, now chipped in by Spezza. McNabb shields off Richie. And as the fourth line goes to work for Toronto, Simmons has to drop that back. Richie and his pass blocked by Carrier. Now Spezza gathers it up. Jason Spezza centers it, skipped away from Simmons. He was taken down in front, no penalty coming, and here comes Vegas, three wide. Amadio centers it, goes off Lilligren. Now picked up by Spezza with Simmons. Goes the other way to Lilligren, and McNabb gathers up the loose puck. Start of a four-game road trip for Vegas. It'll continue in Ottawa on Thursday. Long shoot in the first shot of the game. Knocked down by Campbell. Vegas gets its first shot 9.5 minutes into the first period. In comes Tavares for it. John Tavares. Taken down behind the goal. And Dodonov swings that back down the leaf zone. Muzzin goes back, an icing waved off. Muzzin taps it across to Kerfoot. DJ Brody moves in. Looks down for Tavares. Up the other side. Tavares reaching for it. Back at the point is Brody. Feel free to jump in here, right?
No, you're doing a heck of a job, Gord. There's no way you can do this for 45 more minutes, though, but I think you should give it a try.
Kolesar backhands it back now to the Toronto zone. We'll be out of here in 45 minutes, the way they're going. Nylander, rig wide, crisp pass to Matthews, in, shoots, center save, rebound cleared by Theodore. Here's Bunting on it. Bunting swings it back to Matthews. Bumped there by Martinez. Now Theodore tried to clear it out, it bounces right back to Nylander. William Nylander had that go off the leg of Brett Howden. Loose puck along the boards, Matthews drops it back, in comes Nylander. Struck at the last second by Howden. Back in the corner is Dermott. Lots of traffic. Dermott has a look. Drops it back down to Matthews. Matthews to Sandin. And that pass held at the line. Martinez taps it across to Howden. Now Theodore. That lead pass was knocked away from Janmark. And back there, Lilligren the other way. Drops for Marner. In comes Marner, feeds that across, just missed Kerfoot with it. Loose puck in front, backhand shot, score! Mitch Marner, and the Leafs have the lead.
It seemed inevitable that the Leafs were going to be able to jump on the board first. Total domination in the first 11 and a half minutes of this game. A forecheck that leads to a scoring chance, and it's Marner on the board, back-to-back game. Sweet little dish from Tavares after Kerfoot keeps the puck alive. The forecheck's alive. Tavares pokes it out front. Patience, knowing how much time he has, and sweet hands and Mitch Marner's made it 1-0.
The grin is back, figuratively and literally, got his teeth fixed, a couple of root canals. But the mood improving too, as you mentioned. That's goals in back-to-back games for Mitch Marner. And Toronto's got the 1-0 lead. That was 6 minutes without a whistle. Rink wide pass to Petrangelo. Tees it up and shoots. That's just wide. Back the other way. Kasha. And for Engvall, who fires it down. Shot 8-1 Toronto. Petrangelo. Lead pass. For Carrier. Shoots. Goes off a leg and wide. Good look back by Amadio. And poked ahead. So Amadio's first game with Vegas. And look out, Kasha. Hammered down there by Carrier in front of the Vegas bench, and Kasha slowly gets to his feet and makes his way off. Here's Matthews again. And the rush was stopped by Theodore. Bunting digs the loose. Bucky's taken out. Penalty coming out to Vegas. Keegan Kolesar clipped it with a high stick. And the Maple Leafs go to the power play moments after Mitch Marner gave them 1-0 lead in the first period on Molson Canadian Leafs Hockey on TSN.
Drought at the start of the season doesn't really matter anymore. This one's hard work behind the net, a steal of the puck, and a chip into the empty net as Nick Leddy turned it over, and Marner's on the board. But tonight is more of what you see from Marner and what we're more accustomed to. Slick, stylish, and a beautiful finish. The Leafs have the lead here tonight at 1-0 on Marner's second of the season, and now they'll get a 4-minute power play as Keegan Kolesar is in the box for high-sticking Michael Bunting. Here's the play behind the net. Oh, you know what? They've just reversed the call here.
That wasn't his stick.
That is Bunting's stick that hits himself. So Kolesar, who was in the penalty box, has been taken out. You see him standing in front of the Vegas bench. So that power play comes off the board.
And that's reviewable after the playoffs a couple of years ago. The officials can review a high-sticking call. And they've determined that was not Kolesar's stick, so it remains 5-on-5.
I would say a good break for Vegas, but it's the right call. And at a time when they were reeling a bit here, Gord, back on their heels, giving up the one goal, and then they would have been shorthanded again.
There's Wah with a face-off win for Vegas. And Dodonov sends it up for Kolesar. And Riley collide, loose puck picked up by Wah. Nicholas Wah for Kolesar. A lot of unfamiliar names for this Vegas group. Kolesar banks that back, across it goes to Theodore. Tees it up and shoots, pad saved by Campbell. Now Matthews banks it up for Nylander, and Shane Theodore reins back on him. Here's Wah with it. Nicholas Wah drops that back for Kolesar. Was knocked away. Now Brody leads the rush for Toronto as the Leafs are changing. Brody rings that around. Kerfoot on it. Knocked away by Martinez. He and Alex Petrangelo, two veteran defensemen, have both scored Stanley Cup winning goals. Martinez for the LA Kings and Petrangelo for the St. Louis Blues. Tavares off ahead for Marner, broken up by Petrangelo, the King City native. Lifts out ahead, rink wide pass by Howden, broken up by Brody. 7th game tonight. Tavares drops it back for Muzzin. Jake Muzzin, Alex Kerfoot. Kerfoot shoots from a sharp angle. Leonard knocked that away. David Duffy mentioned Robin Leonard's last game here was with the Islanders. Back in 2018, he was brilliant. A 36-save shutout. The Leafs were all over the Islanders that night. And he was fantastic. Simmons. Throws that rink wide to Sandin, but the play's offside at the Vegas line. 5:50 to go in the first period. Toronto, a 1-0 lead in the first.
Carlson Canadian tonight. It's TJ Brody. Earlier this year, Morgan Riley said that Brody loves his hometown of Chatham, Ontario so much, he could be the mayor. He's playing career game number 700 tonight. Coach Sheldon Keefe says Brody is the same guy at the rink, whether he's coming off a good game or a bad game, and that emotional consistency is a key ingredient when it comes to longevity in the NHL, guys.
Fourth round pick of Calgary back in 2008. Longtime defense partner Mark Giordano there. Sandin moves that in. McNabb knocks it down. At the point, kept alive by Sandin, but then bumped out by Janmark. Here's Jason Spezza with it. Spezza lifts it high in the air and back down to Vegas zone. Leonard out to play it. Spezza scoops it up and whips that wide. Janmark to the line, but not out. Now knocked down by Janmark. Appeared to be a high stick, but play continued. Back court to Nylander, to Sandin. Rasmus Sandin taps that down to the Vegas zone. Back goes Haig for it. Nick Haig around for Petrangelo. Off the center ice, that is knocked away. The bad news began for Vegas in the summer. Alex Tuck, a terrific young player, had shoulder surgery. Matthews in, shoots, it was off a leg and out of play. So they lost Tuck for 6 months to shoulder surgery. Then the dominoes began to fall. You lose Max Pacioretty.
So he was hurt on a clearing attempt.
Yes. Mark Stone broke his foot. And then William Karlsson in their last game against Anaheim suffered a broken foot.
Yeah, he was about 3 feet wide of the net, and a one-timer hit him in the foot.
Muzzin, a long shot, bounces down in front, scooped up by Brody.
Just to illustrate, the luck is just terrible.
Nylander, a shot through traffic. Leonard makes the stop. As you said, Ray, they're just treading water now until they get some bodies back. And Chandler Stevenson banks that ahead. Stevenson has a look in front for Carrier, chips it on goal. And Jack Campbell makes a sharp save there. 1-0, the Leafs lead on the goal by Mitch Marner, his second in as many games.
5G look at Mitch Marner's second goal of the season. In the middle of the ice, watch Marner receive the puck, view everywhere around, and then pull this puck tightly into a small space around Jake Lecision, and then slide it around the right pad of Robin Leonard.
This in 5G view gives you the ability to control the angle on every play, zoom in and out, and rotate around the action. Visit tsn.ca/5gview for more info. The Donoff swings that back to Theodore. Long shot, got blocked in front at the foot of Travis Dermott. Now Dermott has it back. Looking ahead for Kasha, who's back out there. Morgan Riley gathers up the loose puck. Riley, too, a candidate for Canada's Olympic team 2022. Here's Theodore on it. Up ahead to Kolesar. Bank down, Brody gathers it back up. Up ahead for David Camp. Sends it back down the Vegas zone. Camp keeps it onside. That shot by Kasha was blocked. Kasha gets it back, blocked again by Watt. Engvall spins and shoots, rebound. Kasha trying to pull that across, and Leonard blocked it.
I think he's going back across to Camp, and Leonard ends up making a pad save on the pass.
Brody back around to Muzzin. Tavares got tied up in the corner. Marsh is a centering pass, knocked away from Riley Smith, and now Muzzin has it. Up ahead for Kerfoot with Marner. Haig ranges back. And Petrangelo chips out ahead of Smith, but the pass was broken up by Tavares along the board. Now picked up by Marner. Marner works back in the corner, swings that back. Looking for a long shot. Leonard's save. And the rebound scooped up by Smith. He can't clear it out. At the line, knocked down by Kerfoot. Gets around Smith. Here's Marner, feeds it back across. Tavares, little head fake back for Marner, and the pass just misfired. Smith pass ahead for Petrangelo. That missed. And that's icing against Vegas. Tired players on the ice for the Golden Knights. And the faceoff back down to their zone.
The entire game's been in the 10 feet in front of Vegas's net, it seems like. Here, Kasha slides this back. He's looking for Camp on the back door. Leonard goes to his right, and as he spread out, his left foot is going to get the pass attempt to David Camp. Another good shift, though, for that line as Keith continually talks to us about how much he appreciates the way that line does their job, gets pucks from the D zone to the offensive zone, and then the big boys can take over.
And now, after that quick freeze by Leonard, Vegas can make a change. Matthews in for the draw. Against Amadio, who was his teammate just a few days ago. Nylander tries to pick that free. Martinez up for Carrier, flips that to center ice. Morgan Rielly being shadowed there by Chandler Stephenson. Bounces back down to Theodore. German for Rielly. And Matthews lifts it back to center ice. Knocked down by Shea Theodore. Lead pass finds Carrier. Shoots. Campbell makes the stop. Amadio is standing loose at the side of the goal. And the soup chant goes up again here in Toronto. Matthews drops it back for Muzzin. Two to go here in the opening period. Simmons chips that back down to the Vegas zone. McNabb goes back for it. To Janmark. Now Simmons down to Spezza. Move that back and have that crunch into the end board by Simmons. And LeCision has it back and sends that to center ice. Move back down the Vegas zone. Icing waved up. Spezza gets there. Leonard knocked that away from him. Jake LeCision got pumped there by Richie. At the line hacked down by Simmons. The play kept onside. Coughlin moved that ahead and scooped up by Krebs. Just four shots for Vegas in this first period. Engvall. And then knocked away by Petrangelo. Kolasar sends it ahead to Donov, moves in. Riveron triangles just wide. And the puck goes over the glass. Another play, another dash rip. Getting it to Donov, who's been hot of late for Vegas.
Not much going for Vegas for the first part of the period, most of the period actually. And then they get two rushes where the Leafs get back a little deep. Dadanoff gets around the back of the net and throws it to the middle of the ice. Here you're going to see Travis Dermott get caught on the outside. He steps up on the Vegas forward Stephenson, but he can't step up because behind him is Carrier. Carrier gets a decent shot on goal that Campbell boxes the save on. He's not had much to do down there, but he's able to make the stop.
Camp wins the faceoff for Toronto. Once again, as you talked about, Ray, the puck winds up in the offensive zone for the Leafs on this shift. Rielly chops it back and Stephenson gathers it back up. Andrew Stephenson rink wide to Petrangelo. Lead pass for Marchessault. Looks ahead for Smith. That was knocked away by Rielly. Stephenson swings that rink wide. It bounced away from Higg and back to center ice. Petrangelo to Chandler Stephenson. Hit the line by Higg. The puck bounces high in the air. Knocked down again by Petrangelo. 9 seconds now of the period. Kolasar to Marchessault. Banks that back, but out of the reach of Higg. The puck back down to the Vegas zone. Maple Leafs go to the dressing room with a 1-0 lead after 20 minutes of shots on goal, 13-4 in favor of Toronto. Coming up, it's our first intermission with James Duthie and the panel.
After the first period of play, the score is your Toronto Leafs 1, the Vegas Golden Knights nothing. Shots on goal are 13 for the Maple Leafs, 4 for the Golden Knights.
Shifts this year, then scored twice in his next 7. Leafs have scored in 6 straight periods now. A 1-0 lead after one. The shots were 13-4. Gord Miller back here with Ray Ferraro. A lot of talk about Marner in that opening period, but you liked Austin Matthews too.
Yeah, I did. We highlighted him before the game and talked about a player that's searching for his game, feels he's in shape, but his timing's not quite there yet. Well, his very first shift of the game, he throws a little dish over to William Nylander, who gets behind Nick Higg. Leonard with a terrific stop. Matthews played about 6.5 minutes in that first period, had 5 shot attempts, 3 of them on goal. Looked dangerous when he was on the ice. That line was zipping, in particular in the first 10 or 12 minutes of the period. There a good chance that Theodore helps Leonard get a pad on, but I thought it was a good first period for Matthews. It looks like Marner's back to feeling it.
How much longer before it's Matthews, too?
He's got one goal in his last 11 games back to last year. But 5 and 5 career games against the Vegas Golden Knights. And you have to say for Vegas, right, probably fortunate it's only a 1-0 game.
Well, Robin Leonard has, despite numbers that don't look so great, has outplayed his team for most of the year. He did it again in that first period. And if Vegas is going to hang tight in this game, it's going to be a lot on Leonard's shoulders till they can try and grind something out offensively.
Here's Brody with it now. TJ Brody up for bunting. Pokes it by Petrangelo and Hague back to pick it up. Now stolen by Nylander in the corner. William Nylander throws that wide of the goal. Thompson. Vegas is interested in a player down the road. Jack Eichel in Buffalo. Matthews pokes out ahead. In comes Austin Matthews. Shoots and a glove save made by Robin Leonard.
Now Leonard faces his fourth shot from Matthews in this game. You see him start the year 1-4, and as Vegas started to find their legs, maybe find their style with the injuries, that the way that they had to play. You look at his back-to-back wins. He's had a couple of terrific nights in a row. And with the Olympics coming up, you would think that Leonard would be in the mix in Sweden.
Chip back down the Leafs zone. Riley goes back and icing called against the Golden Knights.
First time in forever, no Henrik Lundqvist. As we take a look at the first period for Leonard, he's not even warm yet. He's got to stop a Nylander breakaway. Lots of difficult shots with pucks coming to the net and then traffic coming in secondarily. And he gave up the one goal, the beauty, to Marner. But other than that, a really solid first period for Robin Leonard.
Unafraid to express his opinions. When he played in Ottawa, he had a fish tank with piranhas in it. Named them after Ottawa sports writers. Leonard back with a long shot, and Leonard makes a stop on that. Liljegren spins it back across to Riley. Up for Kerfoot. See Theodore Martinez defending. That's taken away from Kerfoot. Now Theodore with it. Here's Nick Watt. Up in for Janmark. Fed down and Campbell. Out to stop that, whips it back around for Brody. Matthews drops it back for Bunting. And his shot goes off a leg, up and out of play. We mentioned Shea Theodore. A couple of years ago, he played for Canada at the World Championship and failed the drug test. Now, in elevated levels of testosterone, they said, well, you're either doping or there may be something medically wrong. He came home, had some tests done. They found early stage testicular cancer, which causes elevated testosterone levels. That failed drug test turned out to be a very good development for him. Fully healthy now and likely heading to the Olympics. And now a penalty coming to Vegas, and this one won't be wiped out as Kolesar's was in the first period. Toronto's going to the power play.
Yeah, this is going to be tripping on Braden McNabb.
Number 3, Vegas, 2 minutes tripping.
So Toronto's power play that's 4-for-27. We'll go up against Vegas. Vegas got one shorthanded goal on the season. Riley Smith has it.
One more power play goal they've got this year. Still haven't scored a power play goal this
season.
That's
just hard to believe. Just 15 power plays, though, Gord, in 8 games for the Knights.
Leafs power play scored against Detroit the other night. Prior to that, they're 0-for-17 in the previous 6 games. Carter centers it in, comes running a shot, Leonard to stop, but it's tripping towards the goal, and Robin Leonard corrals the loose puck. It's not always an oil painting, but Leonard keeps it out.
Well, the Golden Knights overcommit on the boards here. You got all 4 guys on one side of the ice. That leaves the cross seam open. Morgan Riley's clean coming in from the point. Leonard stops most of this, and then the stick of Martinez beats the stick of Tavares to the loose puck in the blue paint to keep this a 1-0 game.
Now Tavares with a face-off against Waugh. Matthews poking at it. Smith can't clear it out. Here's Marner. Drops for Riley across the Matthews, a shot whistle that wide, and Leonard knocked the net off. Accidentally, you would surmise, but.
Yeah, what I would say is as he slides across here into the net, that yellow peg doesn't have a chance against Robin Leonard.
Leonard's listed at 250.
I mean, he's a big man and he's moving to his right. He runs into the net and the thing pops off. If that was more time in the zone, I would think, yeah, he's probably trying to bump it off. That's too early in the play. I don't think anything other than that yellow peg's not holding the net down.
Stevens with a face-off, not done fairly. Vegas is 28th in the league in face-off percentage with so many young players in the lineup. At one point, Vegas had 13 guys on the injured list in the American League. Marner drops it back to Riley, in for Matthews. Being shadowed by Petrangelo, Matthews drops it back to Riley. Long wrist shot that hit Martinez in front. Marner drops it back for Nylander. That was blocked by Stevenson. Marner back around for Tavares. Janmark hacks at the puck and sends it back down to the Leaf line. Riley up ahead for Tavares with an assist on the Marner goal in the first period. Marner pivots back. Matthews chips it back for Nylander. Back to Matthews for Nylander. Matthews drops it down, Tavares pulls it free and shoots, and Leonard makes a stop on that. Marner back with it. Patting here with Petrangelo, slides it across for Nylander. Feeds it back, Matthews, a shot, scores! Austin Matthews, power play goal, and Toronto leads 2-0.
When we were talking to Sheldon Keefe this morning, he told Gordon and I he had a feeling tonight was going to be a good one for Matthews. Gord asked him, how accurate are you with that? He says, well, I don't know, maybe it's more hope than anything else. A terrific feed from Nylander goes behind Tavares driving the net. He zips this across, and we've seen this countless times from Matthews. The catch and release, like very few players in the National Hockey League. He's on the board. The Leaf power play has scored in back-to-back games, and it's 2-0. Goals on Marner and Matthews.
And as Keith said to us this morning, it's never a bad guess to say that Matthews has a good chance of scoring that night. So that's 6-6 games for him against Vegas. As Wall moves in and goes off a leg, and bounces back to Campbell, still loose in front. And Jack Campbell corrals the bouncing puck.
Now here's the difference when players are on their forehand sides. It starts with Marner winning the puck away from Petrangelo. So Nylander's now got it on his forehand. He can hold that and wait for the play develops. He zips it through the seam, and Petrangelo's not able to deny that pass across, and Matthews rips it past Robin Leonard. It all starts, though, Gord. It may be an unremarkable play, but it's Marner winning that puck on the boards from Petrangelo to keep possession of the puck and allow Nylander and Matthews to do their thing.
Coming in, Cam trying to play it across. That's blocked by McNabb. Now the clearing attempt bounces off the glass, up and out. So Marner's got a couple of points tonight. You know, we talk about it so much, Ray. The first 10 games of the year, good or bad, get emphasized so much.
Certainly, if this is in the middle of February, you might not think about it, an 0-for-17 on the power play. But at the start of the year, it looks terrible, and your percentage is down. You're 26th in the league, and you're like, wait a minute, we got all these great players. How come we can't score in the power play? Well, now you got power play goals in back-to-back games, and you can maybe exhale a little bit.
Betsa wins that drop back to Lundgren. His shot dribbles down towards the goal. Richie trying to bank that back across. Howden can't clear it out. Simmons now. Wayne Simmons lines that back to Sandin. A shot that was blocked and now moved ahead by Amadio. His stick is broken. And the Leafs are hollering he was playing with a broken stick. Lundgren got it knocked down by Theodore. Sandin back across to Lundgren. Snaps that pass, rink wide to Spezza. Jason Spezza in, shoots, whistle that high. Back goes Sandin. Peyton Krebs bearing in on him. Sandin to Spezza. Spezza whips that pass rink wide to Richie. And back goes Hank to pick it up. Okay, lead pass for Janmark. It was off the linesman's skate. And Kerfoot throws that to an open wing. Grabs, banks that in. Brody back across to Riley. Decision stepped into him. Now Kerfoot banks it back to Riley. Kerfoot playing pitch and catch there with Marner. Marner, rink wide pass. Tomorrow's a hard shot. Leonard makes the stop. Big week for Toronto. You got Vegas here tonight, Tampa's here Thursday, then Boston on Saturday. And Sheldon keeps saying, as much as you try to keep the players focused on what's directly in front, he views this as a big measuring stick week. Kerfoot chips that down. Matthews trying to hunt it down on Theodore. Shane Theodore to Riley Smith. Martinez gathers it back up. And looks ahead to Marchessault. Matthews reaching for it. Martinez trying to poke that away. Liljegren back in the corner for Bunting. Now picked up by Theodore. Shane Theodore has it picked off by Nylander. Nylander looking towards the goal, finally scooped up, and Stevenson moves it ahead to Marchessault. Back goes Muzzin. Ronnie Smith gives him a whack. Liljegren up for Nylander. And William Nylander back with it. Three goals on the year, one of them 5-on-5 in their opener against Montreal. There's an overtime goal, 3-on-3, and a power play goal. Coughlin banks it off the glass, knocked out at center ice by Kemp. Drops it back to Engvall. Engvall trying to shoot, that was blocked by Kolesar. Juan plays it ahead for Dodonov. Back for it. Chip pass led by Amadio, whose first goal was scored against Toronto on this date as a member of the LA Kings. And Amadio falls behind the goal. Spezza stepped into him. Howden tries to poke that, and he was knocked off stride. Brought in now by Carrier. William Carrier works his way in. Drops it back, Howden on it. Simmons steps into him, and now Spezza comes in to help out. Back of the point is Hay. Slides it across, Petrangelo shoots, deflected puck goes wide. Campbell was spilled there as Carrier tumbled into him. Spezza got tied up, and now Simmons moves it back down to the Vegas zone. Krebs up ahead for Petrangelo. Alex Petrangelo works his way in. Back in the corner, Petrangelo gathers it back up, flies it back. Hang a hard shot. Campbell got a piece of that. Sends it up and out of play. Austin Matthews has his second of the year, and Toronto has a 2-0 lead on Molson Canadian Leafs Hockey on TSN.
But Jack Campbell has sure enjoyed playing here at home. What a record since coming to Toronto and playing in this arena. Actually, virtually perfect. The one loss, the one overtime loss. And tonight, seven saves and one stop of William Carrier, who runs into Campbell as he's trying to get towards the front of the net. Carrier's averaged over 3 hits a game in his career. I mean, he's a wrecking ball in a 5-year career. The puck goes into the zone, he's going to make contact somewhere.
Knicks, by the way, have now scored in 7 straight periods. Bouncing puck back down to Campbell, who will quickly glove that.
So you mentioned earlier, Gord, that the Golden Knights are not so great at in the faceoff circle either. And so when you have a team that's decimated with injuries, you try and keep yourself in the game with a bunch of little things. One of them is faceoffs. You can get a scoring chance out of the faceoff. Except when you don't win the draw very often, that disappears too.
In that one, Theodore, a long shot, punched out by Campbell. Here comes Kasha back the other way. Andre Kasha. Lead pass finds Camp. He's poke checked there by Theodore. Oh. Martinez trying to dig that free. It's moved up by Kasha. He got tied up. Kasha's got it back. Andre Kasha shoots. That was blocked by Theodore. Kasha back with it. In for Kent. Now Martinez banks it back. Marchessault was tied up by Muzzin. Kent back with it. And Muzzin gathers it back up. Muzzin to Kasha. And Kasha spins and fires that wide. Engvall spins back in the corner. Drops it back to Marner. I'm sure there's a way to calculate it, but how many times has that camp line started in its own zone and the puck's wound up at the other end of the ice? It's incredible. In comes Marner. Marner drops it back to Tavares. Shoots! He whistled. That's just wide. Back in the point is Lilliger. Rossi goes to Sandin. Martinez. As it picked off by Kerfoot, the centering pass. Moved out by Stevenson and back down the Leafs zone.
One.
Lilliger to Sandin. Up for Kerfoot. Busting in with Matthews and Marner. Pass to Matthews. In shoots. He slipped. That's just wide. Matthews back with it again, stolen away by Watt. Up ahead for Hay. Watt chips that ahead to Donov with it. Get into Donov, a three-time 25-goal scorer in the NHL. He actually played 3 years for Florida, went back to the KHL for 5 years, and then came back to Florida. Signed by Ottawa, then dealt to Vegas. Nylander lost the puck to Amadio. Return pass, bounced away from Higg. Bring the Leafs counterattack. Bunting for Nylander. Nylander drops. Matthews in, shoots off the leg, it bounces wide. Amadio throws that ahead. Petrangelo jumping in. Alex Petrangelo winds in. Feeds it down. The backhand shot by Carrier goes wide. Bunting drops it back. Petrangelo for Higg. Higg shoots. Saved up high by Campbell. Now Petrangelo back with it. Winds and shoots. It's off the leg of Matthews. Nylander. Nifty bank pass ahead for Bunting. Matthews moving in. Nylander shoots. Partly blocked by Petrangelo. Loose puck in front. Bunting digging for it. And Leonard pounces on the loose puck. The Leafs buzzing the Vegas net. And Robin Leonard hangs on. 2-0 Leafs lead here in the second period on Molson Canadian Leafs Hockey on TSN.
Everybody looking at the tablet, see how that 3-on-2 didn't end up in the net, but they do the job in their zone. There's support by Nylander and Bunting up top. Now it's a 3-on-1. The first shot's deflected away by Petrangelo, and then the puck comes to the front of the net, and Bunting standing in the crease again, flailing away at this as Leonard makes one stop, and he's looking around for the rebound. But if the Leafs do a nice job in their zone, if they support the puck, Gord, there's going to be all kinds of chances, it looks like, off the rush against Vegas, who seems to just be hanging on.
Peyton Krebs digging for it. Krebs got spun around, a penalty coming to Toronto, and you mentioned Vegas. The fewest power play opportunities in the NHL so far this year. They'll get their first of this game. They are 0 for 15 on the power play so far this year.
This is a worker's penalty drawn by Krebs as he chips it slowly down the board. You see the stick of Lilligren get across the waist, and the trail official's going to call that. Most every time, Lilligren, who had a real nice night against Detroit, gets called for the minor penalty, and a Vegas power play that's usually got all kinds of options comes onto the ice with a pretty veteran group here, but not much else behind it.
No power play goals on the year. The only team in the league without one. Edmonton's got 12 already this year. And now Theodore has that block. Here comes Marner, shorthanded, and Theodore ranges back to take that away.
He's a good skater. He's probably the one guy that Marner didn't want to be in that race with, as he poked it away and Theodore was able to pivot, turn, and get back to deny what would have been a shorthanded breakaway for Marner. As Marner quickly gets to the puck, and look at Theodore's ease of stride. He's a bigger guy and he's able to cover the ice a little bit quicker than Marner can just get there.
Quite conceivable that Canada's top defense pairing at the Olympics would be two Vegas Golden Knights, Petrangelo on the right side and Theodore on the left. Theodore can play both sides. Now stolen by Kasha with a chance. It's off the stick of Theodore. Up and out of play.
And when you look at the guys out of the lineup and then you look at their power play and where it sits in the last 50 years, you know, Pacioretty's a power play scorer. Stone's so great around the front of the net. Carlson, they never talk about him, except now he's not here, and now they talk about him a lot.
And
they,
Alex Tuck, who's been out all year.
They miss those guys on the power play just a great deal. You lose your shooting option, you lose your best players at handling the puck, and you're 0 for 15.
And here is Petrangelo with it. 8.5 to go in the second period. Drops that back for Krebs. Peyton Krebs up for Chandler Stephenson. And Stephenson spins back, wheels that around. And bounces back to center ice. Peyton Krebs is 20 years of age. Tore his Achilles in his draft here, right before the draft, while training, tore his Achilles tendon. Would likely have gone higher, but was picked 17th overall by Vegas. A player you like a lot at the World Junior Championship.
Relentless. But not just relentless effort and not thinking the game as well. Sometimes guys work hard and they don't see the play as it happens. He's just young. There's a good future in front of him.
Stephenson moves in. That's poke checked away. Picked up by Kemp. Lead pass for Engvall. 30 seconds to go on the Vegas power play. Nick Waugh drops that back for Dylan Coughlin. Lincoln, BC native. Feeds that back to Chandler Stephenson, who was a Stanley Cup winner with Washington in 2018. Marchessault drops that back, picked off by Marner in center, by Kirkwood rather, and sent back to center ice. There's Marner watching Theodore, and Theodore gives it away to Marner. Marner swings that back, and that'll do it for the Vegas power play. No shots on goal now, 0 for 16 to start the year. He drops it back for Marner. Here comes Marner across the line. Nylander jumps on. Riley plays it back around. That's picked off and moved ahead by Theodore, trying to find Kolesar with that pass. Sandin goes back but can't get the icing going. Sandin pokes it there for Riley. Nylander battling for it. And McNabb goes back. Bunting bearing in. Puck still skipping there. Howden back with it. Finally bounces back to McNabb. He got crunched by Matthews. Bunting for Nylander. William Nylander with a chance, and Martinez stymied that rush.
Easy.
Now Martinez. Listen, high in the air. You can hear referee Kevin Pollock saying easy, no extension, warning players about cross check.
That's pretty good communication that makes it pretty clear what they're looking for.
Riley up for Spezza. Nav knocked that down. Feeds ahead for Krebs. Krebs knocked down by Sandin. Played back McNabb. Back around for Amadio. Michael Amadio spins back on Spezza. Amadio. Now Sandin had a stick knocked out of his hands. McNabb shoots at deflected. Campbell makes a good stop. Amadio. Going to keep that alive. A penalty coming now. Simmons. It's called for the hook. Doesn't like it and gets a warning from the official to head to the box, which he will with 5:27 to go in the second.
Looks at the net, but his vision sees the seam. Straight back across to Matthews with Tavares keeping the defenseman deep. Matthews rips this up over the right shoulder of Robin Leonard, and it's 2-0.
TSN 5G View gives you the ability to control the angle in every play, zoom in and out, and rotate around the action. Visit tsn.ca/5GView for more info. Simmons got a warning from referee Kevin Pollock for arguing that call. He said, careful, you'll get another one. End of the debate.
Always does. Right when you get to the, right when the boss says that's about it, you go, oh, okay, maybe I don't have anything else to say. I mean, so I remember.
Now I find out. Stephenson for the face-off on the Vegas power play against Kemp. And Derek Danson sends Kemp out of the circle, so Marner will take the draw. Stephenson wins it cleanly back to Theodore. And Shane Theodore had the puck come out. The play's called
offside. Here's the firepower that Vegas is missing. 5-5 and on the power play. Their first, second, third, and fifth leading goal scorers from last year, all out with injuries. That's 77 of their 190 goals scored last year. And there's George McPhee on the right, the president of hockey operations. GM Kelly McCrimmon on the left. Yeah. Almost a shorthanded breakaway. What can you do?
Well, McPhee and McCrimmon, not much. Just the problem is nobody's coming back quick. Like, the injuries are all at least a month.
Tuck's probably the new year. Pacioretty, maybe mid-December.
Yeah, so you're just hanging on, trying to get enough points to keep yourself in the race for when those guys get back. But I'm looking at this power play here. I mean, these are veteran guys. They haven't even gotten the zone yet.
Stevenson throws it back in front. Marchessault a chance. That's the most dangerous one yet. Campbell will hang on long enough to get a faceoff.
That's their first chance, really, on this power play. You mentioned, Gord, their most dangerous one. But these players have to shoulder the responsibility of those other guys out of the lineup. This is where they're going to get some offense from. And Marchessault drives into that front of the net inside of Brody, takes the pass and forces Campbell into a difficult stop.
In Ottawa on Thursday is Vegas, then Montreal Saturday, Detroit Sunday. Picked free by Riley, Morgan Riley, lead pass to Marner. One-on-one with Trenko, shorthanded. Marner in, shoots, fires that wide. Marchessault back with it. Up ahead for Dodonov. Riley Smith back for Dodonov, steers that on goal, and Campbell makes the stop. So when we first saw him at the World Championship, he was Dodonov. Then he came to the NHL, he was Dadonov. Now he wants to be Dodonov.
It's his name.
It is.
Remember when Hendrik Kalender went to Buffalo, or was he Talinder first?
Kalender became Talinder.
Yeah. And Tony Lidman was another one.
The McCulloch brothers were the worst because you had one in Arizona, one in Ottawa, and they pronounce it differently. In comes Kerfoot. Kerfoot in, shoots, and Leonard gets an arm on that.
At least again, some pretty good chances shorthanded.
In comes Nick Waugh. Now shoots and fires that line up the other side, picked up by Muzzin. Final seconds now. This power play sent back in front. The shot by Amadio goes wide. Muzzin reaches for it. Now move back down to the Vegas zone. Two shots on goal for the Golden Knights. We're now 0-17 on the power play to start the year.
But just think, Gord, you know, we talked about the Leafs power play. They were 0-17. They just had a couple of goals beforehand. Now Vegas is 0-17. They just haven't got anything yet. It's the same run. Pete DeBoer's looking at this and going, I guess the power play's good. And would be nice if we got on the board eventually.
His first game in Toronto, by the way, as the coach of the Vegas Golden Knights. Family in town. Longtime OHL coach who won a Memorial Cup for the Kitchener Rangers back in 2003. He's coached in the NHL every year since 2007.
As a world champion, I prepare to win. I still do today. Every game starts at bet99.net.
DeBoer started in Florida, got fired there. New Jersey hired him right away, got let go there. San Jose hired him right away. And Vegas did the same thing. And he said this morning, no one's going to send you sympathy cards in this league. Decision battles where the puck drops out of his equipment. Matthews centers it. And Nylander, a quick backhand shot, stopped by Leonard.
We talked about their, you know, in the keys to the game, about playing it as tight as you can. They don't really have any choices. So you hope your goaltender, Robin Leonard, gives you a great game, which he has so far through 38 minutes or 37 minutes here. You hope your big boys get rolling. Petrangelo doesn't have a goal yet this year. Him and Martinez were important offensive players for them last year. 9 for Martinez, 7 for Petrangelo. They're going to need more from their older guys here as these young guys try and find their way.
Dermott down to Tavares. John Tavares throws that back ahead for Sandin. Acts at that from the side of the goal. That was blocked by Hay. Now picked off by Nylander. William Nylander to Matthews, who's behind the goal. Matthews flies that back. It was poked away by Amadio. Now Matthews Matthews back with it. Poke check by Howden. He ranges back to the Leafs zone to pick it up. Matthews snaps that pass ahead to Tavares. Tavares after it, tied up by Hake. Spezza comes off the bench. Howden couldn't clear it out. Spezza slides that back for Liljegren. Simmons got tied up in the corner by Howden. Loose puck goes to Richie. Nick Richie hangs it back around. Petrangelo picks it up. And backhands that back down the Leafs zone as Ronnie goes back, being shadowed there by Janmark. Spezza lines that ever Simmons. Off back for Liljegren, but he's got to wait for teammates to get onside, and the shoot-in goes over the glass and out of play.
Leafs 13 shots in the first period, 10 so far in the second period. They've really been in control of this most of the way. The very few chances for Jack Campbell to have to deal with it. You know, Sheldon Keefe was talking about wanting to connect the defense to the forwards, and he thinks there's another level for this team after the back-to-back wins, and they've done what they're supposed to do here through 40 minutes. It hasn't looked scrambly, Gord. It hasn't looked like they've had to race around and try and cover for each other. It's been a real steady 40 minutes.
1:28 to go here in the second period. We'll have the Leafs here against the Tampa Bay Lightning on Thursday night.
Tampa dealing with their own injury problems. It moves Steven Stamkos back to the middle of the ice where the first part of his career was.
Muzzin drops it back for Brody. Marner up for Matthews. Krebs plays it around. And Lecision trying to knock that free. Now Krebs banks it back to Martinez. Lost to McNabb. Carey has stolen away by Marner in the final minute now of the second period. Now stolen by Nylander. Back to Marner. Marner holds. Back down to Nylander. Back to Marner. He's playing keep away here. Riley, a centering pass. Center save. Rebound. Score! Austin Matthews has his second.
Is averted. A couple for Matthews here in the second period. Gord, I was looking down on the ice, and so Sheldon Keefe gets Marner, Nylander, Matthews together here at the end of the period. Carrier is the veteran forward on the ice for Vegas. Krebs and Lecision are the other two. They're in their first year. They're taking baby steps into the National Hockey League, and they're against Matthews, Marner, and Nylander. Eventually, you can't hold against them. Matthews gets a puck that bounces off of Leonard and into the net. He's got two tonight, and the Leafs are up by three.
And now 7 goals in 6 career games against the Vegas Golden Knights. I'm not sure who you want to go to Vegas with more, Matthews or Sheldon Keefe, because Keefe's the guy who said he thought Matthews would score tonight. That long shot goes wide. Theodore long shot, that's blocked. Back at the point, caught on the drive, that goes wide. So Marner and Matthews heating up at the same time. And the Leafs with a 3-0 lead after the opening 40 minutes of the hockey game. Austin Matthews gets his second late in the second period.
You mentioned they're playing keep away around the zone. Marner holding the puck again up top. He finds Riley. Matthews is all alone in front of the net. For just a moment, as Krebs gets back to him, the rebound comes back to Austin Matthews, and came into the game with one. He's got three, and it's 3-0 Toronto.
Coming up, our second intermission with James Duffy. And the Leafs have a 3-0 lead through 40 minutes of play. And it's time now for the EA Sports X Factor Performer of the Game. We look to a player who's having himself a pretty good night.
Yeah, banking on or on the back of a pretty good night against Detroit, Mitch Marner is our X Factor Performer of the Game. 3 points as you mentioned, it comes at both ends of the ice. He does a nice job back checking, scores a gorgeous goal in the first period. This is a confident player here, wins the puck battle, and when you can carry the puck within a foot of your own offensive blue line and not worry about it, he finds Nylander, who finds Matthews. This pass across to Tavares, and then he gets a, he's going to get a, end up with a shorthanded attempted breakaway that Shea Theodore beats him to. He's skated well, he's had the puck, he's created, he picked up an assist on the second Matthews goal as well. 3 points on the night for Mitch Marner.
Nothing like a couple hours of dentist chair, a couple of root canals to make things look up for you.
Well, the results are good. That dentist chair is just no good.
You've never lost a tooth when you played, right?
Hard to believe. Like, hard, seriously, hard to believe.
It's impossible to believe, actually. Here comes Nylander with a steal from Petrangelo. William Nylander in, shoots, Leonard save, rebound, and Bunting turned away by Leonard. Man, the Leafs have had a five-star scoring chance in the first second of every period. Knocked down by Nylander, but a hand pass called against Toronto in the offensive zone.
The first shift of the game, William Nylander had a breakaway on the first shift of the game. This time it's Nylander from the wing, clips Leonard up high, and then Bunting gets inside of Chandler Stephenson. This is just not being ready to play if you're Vegas, and sharp on the puck by the Leafs as Leonard has to make two difficult stops, and the period's not 20 seconds old.
Travis Dermott back out there for Toronto. He missed some time in the second period after blocking his shot. Actually got x-rayed, came back negative. He's back out there now. To which Vegas says, why can't we get news like that? Here's Kerfoot winding through the offensive zone. Alex Kerfoot drops it back to Dermott. Long shot chipped in front by Tavares. Gets it back. And they'll pack, pull back towards the goal and moved out by Theodore. Shea Theodore snaps that pass ahead for Dodonov. It missed him. And Campbell out to play it.
If you're the Leafs here, you want to put this thing away. Don't let Vegas hang around. Don't get sloppy like they did against Detroit, and then all of a sudden your night becomes more difficult than it has to be.
In comes Engvall, bumped by McNabb. Sheldon Keefe talked to us about that this morning. Toronto took the 3-1 lead early in the third period and then let Detroit back in the game. Really went bumped there by Krebs. Krebs trying to steal it away. And Engvall slides it ahead for Camp. David Camp winds it across the line, but Engvall a half step ahead. The play is called offside.
You've got to really accept your role when you're playing on a line like Kampf and Engvall and Kasha. You're not going to score a lot, but your job's to not get scored on, but to have positive minutes on the ice. You have to bury your frustration because these guys think they can score. They think they can contribute offensively, but you better not get caught trying to create and give up at the other end of the ice.
Sandin pokes it back in the corner. Pauka crunched there by Simmons. Tag lead pass for Petrangelo. And Sandin pokes that ahead. You mentioned Alex Petrangelo doesn't have a goal yet this year. 6 times in his career, he has scored 10 plus goals in a season. He was on pace to do it again last year in the shortened season. For Amadio back down the Leaf zone. If Vegas puts Amadio back on waivers this season, Toronto would get the first crack at him, having lost him previously. Nylander tries to drop that back. Bunting tries to feed it back, and it's picked off by Smith. Riley Smith moves that ahead. Riley Smith acquired by Vegas from Florida prior to the expansion draft for a 4th-round draft pick. Here comes Nylander busting in. Pat Martinez should score! William Nylander! And it's 4-0 Toronto, and all the big guns are firing tonight.
Nylander's shot is a perfect one. Let's go back to the first period where Matthews finds Nylander. And Nylander's going to come to the net and try and go back across the seam. Leonard makes the save. This time it's Bunting across. Different play, different period, different shot. Perfect release by Nylander. Beats Leonard over the pad. and it's 4-0 as the Leafs are running all over top of Vegas.
Fourth of the year for Nylander. His second 5-on-5 goal of the year. And Toronto a commanding lead on the Golden Knights. The last time they met, Vegas handed Toronto its fifth straight loss. And Mike Babcock was fired the next day as coach of Toronto. So Sheldon Keefe, his first time coaching against the Golden Knights. Dodonov back with it. Deep pass for Kolesar that bounced off his skate. And Marner's back to pick it up. Well, Sheldon Keefe said to us this morning, only a matter of time before the big guns got on track. And the faucet wide open here tonight. Back at the point is Liljegren. Brings it back around to Kemp. Kemp centers it, knocked away by Leonard. Back is Sandin to pick it up. Kasha's trying to make his way off. He might have been shaken up with that play. Now heads back to the Toronto bench, grabbing his right arm. And there's Liljegren with it. Leonard out to pick it up. Drops it back to Hank Ritchie. Now Simmons came in on Howden. Loose puck goes to Amadio. Takes the return pass, tries to kick that ahead. Amadio, that wrist shot was blocked by Muzzin. Back at the point, Petrangelo. And swing it back ahead, picked up by Spezza. Spezza up for Ritchie, stolen by Petrangelo. And in comes Petrangelo. And Mark tied up by Ritchie in the corner. And Muzzin back on it. Ritchie gathers up the rolling puck for Brody. Leads for Spezza. His poke checked there by Coughlin. Now Simmons is buying some time to complete the change and sends it down to the Vegas zone. Petrangelo back to the Leaf line. Riley knocks it down for Dermott. Vegas just 14 shots, 5 minutes into the third period. So much went right for Vegas the first 4 years in the league, and now so much has gone wrong in the first month and a half of this NHL season. In comes Chandler Stevens and drops that back for Smith with a shot. He whistled that high. McNabb back with it to Smith. Back across to Theodore, shoots, and Jack Campbell makes the stop.
Well, Nylander's going to score here. He reads the play as Brody chips it up the boards and sees that Bunting wins that puck battle. As soon as he sees that puck is 50-50, Nylander's off to the races. And Martinez isn't going to catch him, but this shot is perfect. Just inside the post, over the pad. Three goals for the Matthews-Nylander-Bunting line. A goal and a couple assists for Marner.
Nice pass from Nylander to Bunting.
Bunting to Nylander.
Well, he said, but Nylander said nice pass.
Oh, I see, yes. I'm playing along now. I'm getting it.
Picking up what I'm putting down now?
Yeah, I got it.
Up for Tavares, and Martinez knocks it down. Or Wah. Tavares right back with it. Tavares moves in. He's poke checked off the puck by Martinez. Dodonov drops it across to Krebs. Krebs. And behind the goal is Muzzin. Kemp back with it. Drops it back to Sandin. There's Kemp knocking it down. And moved ahead by Carrier. Got rocked there by Muzzin. Now Kemp back with it. Got poke checked off the puck. And Muzzin back for it. Back around to Brody. Brody with an assist on the Nylander goal. Brought in by Spezza. Ritchie poking at it. Howden back with it for Pietrangelo. Rink wide to Amadio, and that plays offside at the Toronto line. William Nylander has his fourth goal of the year. And Toronto's got a 4-0 lead on Vegas. A Molson Canadian Leafs hockey on TSN.
And he's got enough room to deliver that shot. You see the movement of Leonard to his left. That opens up just over the pad, and Nylander hits it, and it's 4-0 Toronto.
TSN 5G View gives you the ability to control the angle on every play, zoom in and out, and rotate around the action. Visit tsn.ca/5G View for more info. Toronto Leafs, the fourth year of that 6-year extension he signed. Stevenson plays it across McNabb with a shot. That's snagged by Jack Campbell.
It's funny how time goes. You know, you remember the Ovechkin contract, the long one that he signed. Yeah. You're like, how did he get to the end of that thing? The years just melt together, and Jack Campbell is playing his way into a decision for Toronto, too. Contractually coming to the end of his deal and
unrestricted at the end of the year,
has done everything they possibly could have hoped for when he came in the trade from Los Angeles.
And now with Mrazek back and healthy, Sheldon Keefe will have to decide how to manage the goaltending situation. Matthews got crunched there by McNabb. Bunting plays it back in. Chipped ahead just on the reach of Riley Smith, and Campbell back for it. Pleasant. And they go off the official, Kevin Pollock. Here's Marchessault back with it, taken down by Bunting. And Muzzin finds Nylander. And rink wide pass disrupted there by Coughlin. And Dylan Coughlin. And rink wide for Kolesar. Sandin steps into him. Muzzin and roll off his stick. Bouncing puck goes to Waugh with a quick shot. Campbell makes the stop on that.
Good track by Campbell as Waugh goes across the slot left to right, and Campbell's patiently in position and tracks across with very little movement, maybe just one or two pushes from Campbell with his right leg to stay square to Waugh, and the save's made with his body, and the puck just falls to his feet.
Off the drop. Here's Theodore across the top. Shoots. Campbell saved. A couple of good chances for Vegas the last minute or so. And now here comes Toronto. 2-on-1. Kerfoot flips to the head. In comes Marner. Holds and shoots. And Leonard makes the stop. Thrown back in front. Leonard spun around. Still loose. And somehow the puck stayed out. Now Sandin fires. He ripped it wide. Liljegren feeds it back to Marner. Marner shoots. Tipped in front by Kerfoot. That's just wide. Wraparound try for Tavares. Here's Kerfoot back for it. Marner back with it. Toronto all over Vegas here now. Marner back for Liljegren. Back to Marner. Long wrist shot. Hit a leg in front to Donov on it. Takes down Marner. And Marner in the corner lost the puck to Martinez. What a flurry for the Leafs there.
Amazing the puck doesn't go in. A couple of really close attempts as Leonard somehow keeps the puck out of the net.
Head back down the loop zone. Morgan Rielly back to pick it up. Now behind the play, we got too many men on the ice called. And it's the Leafs who will be penalized here.
Yeah, Tavares is heading
too many men
across the ice. Here's the 2-on-1 earlier. Marner tries to slide, fake shot, slide and open up Leonard, who makes the stop. He wants to go through the legs, but Leonard's able to stop it. Then the puck's in the crease, and how that thing doesn't go in is hard to believe. And here's another stop by Leonard. Tavares picks up a loose puck and tries to wrap this back around the front of the net.
So Vegas back on the power play. Here comes Kasha, shorthanded with Kent. Andre Kasha. Knocked down there by Smith. Vegas 0-for-17 in the power play to start this year. Chandler Stevenson winds it across the line. And you always say injuries aren't an excuse, but they are a reason.
Sometimes they're the fact. They're the main fact of what's going on here. I mean, this is not the Vegas Golden Knights. They're missing five players, four forwards that are really amongst the very core of their forward group. It's just not the same team. You can work as hard as you want, you just don't have the same people in the same places.
Martinez tried to put that head set down the ice by Muzzin. Vegas' power play woes go back to last year's playoffs. Remember the series against the Montreal Canadiens in the conference final? They did not score a power play goal in that series either. They went 0 for 17 their last 8 games in the playoffs. So they're 0 for the last 34 on the power play back to last year's playoffs. That's hard to fathom. In comes Krebs. Back to Kolasar. Now Martinez trying to corral the rolling puck. 20 seconds to go on the power play. Here's Krebs with it. Peyton Krebs drops it back to Waugh. And move back down the ice as Kampf got a stick on that.
It's not that they're only not scoring, Gord. They're not even close.
And no shots on this power play. They have just 18 in the game. Carrier with it. Now a bouncing puck in front that was knocked away from Houghton, brought back by Tavares. That puck skips high off the glass. Marner back for Tavares. McNabb with it. Mario pokes that around Sandin, works it and shoots. Campbell the pad save. Tavares back with it. Here's McNabb. Around he goes to Coghlan. Back around Matthews, chipped it there. Now banked back up by Nylander. The Tampa Bay here on Thursday. Boston Saturday, and the LA Kings here on Monday. That's bounced back down. Leaves up icing called against Vegas. Don't miss new episodes of the Emmy-winning show, Some Call, one of the best series in HBO history, Succession. Is fantastic, by the way.
This is one of your calls right here. You're a fan of this.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Now streaming only on Crave. Seven and a half to go here in the period. And Smith with it. He goes to Stevenson, drops it back, Smith back across for Marchessault on a back check. Austin Matthews knocked that away. Petrangelo, a long shot, punched away by Campbell. Bounces back to Nick Hague, who flipped that wide, and now Muzzin back on it. So if you're Vegas, you got to start looking. How can you squeeze some points on this road trip? But those Nylander between the legs to clear that away. And they're in Ottawa in a couple of days. Montreal on the Saturday. Detroit in a back-to-back. You said at the start of the show, Ray, they just got to tread water here and try to hang in it until they get some people back.
One of the things...
Wow, a little dangle trickles down. Campbell knocks that away.
They felt was they had started to find a little bit of an identity, and then Carlson got hurt again. Not again, but got hurt last game. Now they lose another key player.
They beat Anaheim in a shootout Friday night. They blew a 3-goal lead in the third period, but wound up getting the win. Here's Petrangelo, tees it up and shoots. That went through, and Campbell made the stop. Back at the point, Hague, a long shot, hit a skate. Dodonov back with it. Taken down by Dermott. Waugh flips it back in front. Hague with a pick chance. Campbell the same. And back comes Toronto the other way. Simmons. Jumps in on Petrangelo. Wayne Simmons throws it back in front. Is off a skate wide. Back at the point is Sandin. Across to Liljegren. Back for Spezza. Jason Spezza. Long shot. Tipped wide of the goal by Richie in front. Petrangelo. Kind of came center ice, but Lilligren lifted his stick and took the puck away. 5.5 to go in the third period. Andre Kasha. And across the line, back that down. Leonard for Krebs. Up to Martinez. He was tied up by Engvall at center ice, and now Kasha has it back. Muzzin. Lines in across the line. Engvall hustles there for Toronto. Martinez plays it away to Theodore. Around the decision. Carrier drops it off for Krebs. Carrier centering pass in behind decision. Off back at the point. Teed up by Coughlin. That shot misfired. The line held by Coughlin. And now Marner tries to kick it ahead. Hang ball. Up for Tavares. Knocked down by Janmark. Here's Marner back with it. Marner backs it off the glass, trying to find Kirkwood. And Coughlin scoops it back down the ice. This will be an icing call against the Golden Knights.
It's been a pretty quiet night for Jack Campbell, but he makes a terrific stop off of Nick Haig. Haig comes in from the point here, and he's going to knock this out of the air. Campbell comes across and makes the left pad stop.
Now a tripping puck goes down to Leonard, and he'll hang on to that. Jack Campbell standing tall on the Leaf goal. Latest stop on Nick Haig to keep it a 4-0 lead on Molson Canadian Leafs Hockey on TSN.
Toronto Maple Leafs Hockey on TSN is proudly presented by Molson Canadian. Nominate yourself or a fellow fan today for the Molson Hall of Fame. Must be legal drinking age. No purchase necessary.
So Sheldon Keefe coaches his first game against the Vegas Golden Knights, and things are going very much his way this evening, and he'll face the Boston Bruins for the first time on Saturday. He was shaking his head at how hard that is to believe, but of course the schedule last year dictated that. The Leafs had played all their games against Boston already when he took over in November of 2019. Riley. Back to Simmons. Picked up by Amadio. 4 to go here in the third period. Howden for the trailer. McNabb, and Riley actually moved that wide. Amadio tied up by Spezza. Back at the point, McNabb drops it back to Coughlin. His long shot goes way wide. Played back in by Janmark. Spezza up ahead for Simmons. And Coughlin plays it back across to McNabb. Matthews slides that back down to the Vegas zone. Back goes Martinez for it. Law had it stolen by Bunting. Nylander back with it. Across the Lilligren. Sandin to Bunting. Looks ahead for Nylander, who sweeps that down to the Vegas zone. A funny bounce in the corner. Theodore had to gather that up quickly. And now Theodore. Offered it on off. Back to Theodore, whistles it back down to the Leaf zone. Brody bats at it. Now Coughlin back for it. He's taken down there by Engvall. And the puck back to center ice. Kasha. Gives it deep for Kemp. Now Engvall centers, and it bounced away from Kasha. Line held by Muzzin. Feeds it across. Brody a long shot. Leonard got a piece of that. Kasha sends it back in. Sheldon Keefe has juggled the top two lines a couple times, but the bottom two have remained very much intact. He's pleased with them and pleased with tonight with a 4-0 lead on Vegas.
...31 against Detroit on the weekend. Jack Campbell gets the start here in the first game of this week against Vegas. Not very busy in the first period, only 4 shots, 10 in the second period, 10 here in the third. His best stop was the one on Nick Hague, but 24 up and 24 down for Campbell, and he's looked really solid doing it. You mentioned, Gord, with Mrazek back, now they can settle into whatever goaltending rotation they had initially thought that they were going to go with.
Riley banks it back in, picked up by Richie. Richie drops it back for Spezza, that's poked away by Amadio. Now Riley swings it back across to Dermott. That puck deflects into the Vegas bench. Pete DeBoer will look on and try to find some answers as they move on to Ottawa on Thursday.
I think the first line of duty for the coaches is to identify who can do what for them. The more they watch them, they can see what is each young player capable of. What type of role can they put them in? Can they spread their veterans around three different lines, or do they got to load up a couple of veteran lines and hope they can check with the younger guys? All things that have to be evaluated before their next game.
Here's Dermott with it. Cross to Riley. Knocked down at center ice by Coughlin. And Peyton Krebs. 50 mover on Engvall. Drops it back to Coughlin. His long shot deflects wide. Now Amadio back with it. Krebs was knocked down. McNabb plays it back to Coughlin. Winds and shoots. Campbell a pad save. Rebound! And Krebs turned away by Campbell with 1 minute to go in the third period.
Well, as the game's gone on, Peyton Krebs has become more noticeable. He's going to make a pretty sweet move here around Engvall. Up near the blue line, that's a confident play. And then Coughlin's going to get the point shot turned aside by Campbell. And the lengthy rebound easily stopped by Campbell.
That's it for the defensive zone faceoff against Waugh. Spezza wins that draw. Sandin moves it around. Simmons chops at it. And Lecision plays it back in. Kolasar trying to center it. Knocked down neatly by Lilligren. And Simmons holds and moves the puck out. Fires that down the Vegas zone. Richie on it. Richie centers it. And that's knocked down by Waugh. Martinez banks that ahead. And as he does, that's icing against Vegas. The faceoff back down to the Golden Knights zone.
Well, this will just lengthen out the night for Vegas as they want to get out of here at this point.
They will tonight. Charter flight to Ottawa and then try to regroup against the Senators. Face off, one back to Sandin. A long shot that's deflected away. Sandin gets it right back. Plays in the corner for Kasha. Martinez tied up by Engvall. Lecision plays it ahead for Kolasar. And Campbell up to play it. Brings it high off the glass to Engvall. Wrestling along the boards with Kolasar. And the Leafs dominate from the opening puck drop, win it by a final score of 4-0. Jack Campbell makes 26 saves for his fifth career shutout, his third with Toronto. As the Leafs run their winning streak to 3.
On a night that set up pretty well for Toronto, a Vegas team banged up and injured. Marner coming off a good game against Detroit. And now they hope for Matthews to get rolling, and Marner's got 3 points. Matthews got a couple of goals, and all seems well as the Leafs, as you mentioned, have won their third straight.
And time now for tonight's Molson 3 stars, and Jack Campbell gets a shutout but doesn't get a nod as one of the top three, as Vegas didn't threaten a lot. Marner a goal and 2 assists, Matthews 2 goals, and Nylander a goal and an assist, as Toronto wins it by a final score of 4-0. Next stop for us on Molson Canadian Leafs Hockey will be Thursday night as the defending Stanley Cup champions are in town. The Tampa Bay Lightning in Toronto. Coverage starts at 6:30 Eastern time on TSN4. For Ray Ferraro, Mark Masters, all of us at TSN, I'm Gordon Ono. Thanks for tuning in. Now stand by for SportsCenter with Ben Sheeler and Jennifer Hedger.